Hey everybody, this is Ori from AstroWeb, and I'm going to showcase how to use Shopify to import products in bulk using a spreadsheet or a CSV file. Okay, so why would we actually need to import and use a spreadsheet? So I'll give you a few examples. So number one is you want to make things in bulk, right? So you want to have one spreadsheet. You can easily add a ton of products and then import it. If you don't do it via spreadsheet, you have to go to the back end, click on products, all products, click on add product, and do them one by one, right? So if you do them one by one, it's going to take a ton of time to do it if you have like a ton of products, okay? The other reason is sometimes you want to keep like a central, kind of like a database or a central sheet, a central file for all of your products, and you only want to update that general or central file and then upload things. So there's a few reasons why you might want to have it, this video I'm going to showcase to you how you actually do it. So first of all, before you actually go and start making a spreadsheet, this spreadsheet has to have a certain format, right? So a certain amount of columns, certain amount of data, certain data is required, certain data is optional. So how do you know that, right? You're not going to start remembering how many columns you have. So the easiest way to do it is you go to the back end, click on products, all products, and you actually via the back end upload a few different products. So for example, I have some products right here I've uploaded. Now, when you upload a few products, how do you know how many products you need to do in order to start this kind of template? So the way I like to think about it is you want to upload one product for each type of different type of variation that you have. So for example, I'll give you an example. I have a collection page right here, and I have five products. They're all Adidas related. So this is related to my Adidas collection. Now, I have a simple product, so a product that has no variations, no price differences, it's not a bundle, it's nothing. The customer can go here and actually go and add to cart and buy. They can't do anything else other than, you know, browse and buy. The other types of products I have are variant products. So for example, if I have a shoe, then the customer can select sizes and colors. So the way you upload a product like this, that it is a variant product, is you're going to set up a ton of products. So for example, you have inventory for, you know, white five, white six, white seven, white nine, etc. And if you have more colors, you would. So what you want to do is try to upload one of each different strange type of product that you have. So in this case, I only have two different types of products. So what I want to do is I go here to upload. I've already done it before, but if you were to do that, you click on add product, you'd create your new product, create the images, create the pricing, make sure you have a few variations of pricing, compare, cost per item, all these things, inventory, etc., or stock, etc. Inventory we'll talk about a little bit later. Now, if you have, you know, some that are physical products, some are not physical products, you're going to want to put these variations. So one type of product in the back end for each different type. Now I only have two. These are very similar. These shoes are very similar to these shoes. These backpacks are very similar to each other. So once I actually did that, I'm going to go back to all products and I'm going to click on the export. Okay. So to make it easy, I'm going to actually, because I have more products, I'm going to search here and I'm going to click on export, and you have a few options here. So really simple. So either you can export only the current page, right? So only these products, in this case, five, because I've searched, or you can export all products in the catalog. So if I have 10,000, it'll take a while to give it to me, but it'll give me 10,000, or selected products, only if I've actually selected these, right? So I can do that, or the actual products matching my search. So if you've actually searched here, you'll see that. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to export right now, just for example, these two products. Let's do these two. Okay. So I'm going to click on export, and I'm going to click on the selected ones, and I'm going to click on export. Okay, now if you've noticed, now I have it here. I'm going to upload it to Google Sheets. And the reason I just like to have an easy, accessible cloud version that I can access. So for example, if I need to give it to a colleague, I can give it to them. It doesn't have to be saved on my computer, especially if I want a centralized spreadsheet that others can work on. Okay, so I'm going to click and open this. Okay, and one more thing about the export, sorry, is you have two different types of exports. Export as a CSV for, you know, Excel or numbers, etc., or a plain CSV. Both of them are okay. If you actually open it in Google Sheets, and then later on we'll show you that you actually have to export it into a CSV. But both of them are okay, just it's up to your preference. Okay, so now that I've exported it, you see I have, right now I have 9 rows. Okay, so if you remember, I only exported 2 different types of products. Okay, so let's look at it for a second. So the first product is a sticker. Okay, and so the sticker right here is this product right here, this row. So every product, every physical good, every SKU, every product that you upload is going to be its own row. Now, if you remember, we have 2 different products. So why do I have 8 rows instead of just 2 rows? The reason for that is I've exported a simple product that doesn't have variants, and I've exported a product, if you click here, that has many variants. If you remember, white size 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, etc. So if I scroll down here, you'll see all of these. So every variant you have here will be its own row here. Okay, so you can see right here. So let's start with the most simple one here. So first of all, every first row is going to have the actual column names. These are going to represent what you have to put in and what you should not put in. And the reason why I mentioned that you first want to create a product in the back end and then export and then use that as a template is it's sometimes not so intuitive what some of these things mean. For example, publish, true or false, things like that. So let's review. So handle, this is basically the URL. This is a unique identifier of the product. This is the product name. This is the product description, right? So if I go here and I edit a product, this is my description. Obviously, I don't have anything here. This is the vendor, the type, the tags. These are all these things on the right-hand side here, okay? I have the publish. Is it published? True. Is it visible? Online published, true or false? And then I have options. Okay, these are only going to be filled out if you have variant products. So here there's no variant, so I just use the title, default title. But when you see here, let's show you an example. I'm going to go here to this one, Superstar 80s. So I'm going to go here, and if you notice here, my first one is size, color, price, quantity, SKU, right? So size, okay, size 5, size 6, etc. If you notice, there's a lot of blank spaces. This is exactly why you need to make things in the back end and then use the template. You want to keep these blank spaces, right? So this is kind of like the main product, and these are all the variants. Okay, I hope that makes sense. If you have any questions on this video, happy to answer in more detail. Or even if you have some specific ones, you can send to me a CSV. I'd be happy to debug them. Okay, so again, size, these are all the sizes. Color, these are all the colors. Very simple, right? So size, colors, okay? And option 3, I don't have a third variant, but if there are, you can have up to 3 variants in Shopify, okay? The SKU, these are the SKUs. Really simple here, the SKUs right here. And the actual weight. And obviously we're using Shopify basic for inventory. This is the inventory amount. Variant inventory, nope. They're all using the same. And variant price, right? So you're gonna keep, you're just gonna copy. If you're not sure when you make something, you're just gonna copy it when you add new rows, okay? Variant compare, no. And requires all, so these are all the defaults. You can all keep these the same. These are images, right? So if you upload an image, for example, here, this image URL would be here, okay? Image position, by default, it'd just be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay? And alt text, this is for SEO. So does the image, okay, have some kind of alt text right here? You know, shoes from above, okay. And is it a gift card, yes or no? True or false, excuse me. SEO title, SEO description. SEO title, SEO description. It would be what you put in right here. And all of these are Google Shopping. So if you have a Google Shopping channel, right here, if you have a Google Shopping channel, then it can export that. Now, if you don't have it, you can just keep it all blank. and then here's the weight, and that's it. So this is for a simple product. Now for the variant, you can see very simply, every variant has these data, you can just fill it in, and that's it. So this is what you do. So now let's assume I wanna add a new simple product, just like this. What I can do is I can copy this, and let's just call it fake sticker, okay? And I can just call it fake sticker. So you see, the way I'm copying and pasting, it makes it very easy for me to figure out, is it under the Adidas vendor? What's my description? So this is a test description, okay? I wanted to publish it. I don't have variants, good, okay? The weight, okay, good. My inventory, let's say I have 981. And what's my price? You see, I'm basically reviewing the one I copied from, and I'm looking at the column name. Let's say this is actually a 395, okay? And images, obviously, if I have a different image, I'm gonna put, let's show another image right here. Let me take an example. Let me find another image from our site just for a second. Let me grab a new image that we haven't processed yet. So let's just take this for example. I'm gonna copy the full URL, HTTPS, et cetera, et cetera. I'm gonna put it here, okay, as an image, and it'll download that image. Image position one, it's not a gift card, and that's it. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go here and I'm gonna click on file and download as a CSV. You cannot export as an Excel, you have to do as CSV, and you downloaded it right here. Now I'm gonna go to my system, products, all products, and I'm gonna import. Okay, so I'm gonna import, okay? And then when you import, you're gonna select the file from your computer. Okay, so I just made this one right here. And you're gonna specify here, replace any current products that have the same handle. So if I re-uploaded, obviously I have the same handle. So if I change anything right here, for example, I decided that I wanna change the type from shoes to, you know, anything else. Let's just call it socks, okay? Then it'll actually override the specific row with the new data, okay? So let's go here. And let's go upload. So I click here. I actually do want to replace it, and I'm going to click on upload. Okay. Now what it does, it actually uploads to the system, and it processed an example, right? So it's going to give you a preview to show, to give you a feel if you've done this correctly. So it says you're trying to import three products, which is correct, because I really have one product with variations, another one, and another one. Okay. And it says, okay, I have 9 SKUs, and I have 7 images. Do you want, you will overwrite, are you sure? Here's an example, and it gives you some examples, okay? And I'm gonna click, if everything looks good, you're gonna click on start to import. Now what it's doing is it's gonna start to import. So if you have only a few products, it'll finish quickly. If you have a lot of products, you have to come back later for it, okay? So let's go here and let's find this new product, okay? So let's actually search for sticker. Okay, so now if you notice here, I have a fake sticker button. Sorry, fake sticker product. And so you notice fake sticker, this was the description we added. Here's the product type, the vendors, the image we uploaded, right? Because we copied the image from here, the price, and you know all this information, the inventory, etc., right? So that's it. Really, really simple. So the key for this whole thing is you always want to add products with all the data you can here, right? So I suggest just basically upload a few different types of products, fill up as much information as you can to mimic the different types of products you would actually manage via your spreadsheet. Go ahead, double check yourself, and then go from there, okay? There's only one more comment I can think of right now, which is in the future, if you actually want to manage your inventory. Let's say you already have all your products, you're not changing the products. The inventory changes, right? So we have inventory right here. The inventory changes you want to do, you should not, assuming you're not adding new products, the inventory changes should not be done via this spreadsheet. I'm going to make another video, which we'll link to in this description, which will show you how you actually have the inventory uploads it changes, assuming you know you have changes, right? So it actually would be here, but I'm going to make another video for that. So I'm going to link to that. Okay. So hope this makes sense. If you have any questions, let me know. Thank you very much for listening to the video, and looking forward to making more and more tutorials. Thank you.